Hi friends, welcome to our channel. In the previous session we had discussed regression trees. Now we will move to clustering trees. So here the clustering is an unsupervised learning. Regression is a supervised learning. Then by using this supervised learning, I am constructing an unsupervised learning. Remember the definition of a regression tree. The regression tree finds an instance space segment. The regression tree finds an instance space segment whose target values are tightly clustered. Remember this point. We have find a segment, instance space segment. The target values are tightly clustered around the mean of the cluster. The target values are tightly clustered around the mean of the around the mean. That means it forms a cluster. That means by using regression tree, I am constructing a clustering tree. And the variance of set of target values. The variance of set of target values is the average squared Euclidean distance to the mean. That means how to calculate the variance? The variance is calculated by using the average squared Euclidean distance to the mean. Suppose this is one item. We are calculating Euclidean distance to the mean and perform square operation and finally perform average of all the items. And one more point is, in clustering, to check whether the elements or whether the samples present in the cluster are similar or dissimilar, we are using a dissimilarity function or a distance function. Suppose dissimilarity function, how we define dissimilarity function on the instance space? Suppose dissimilarity function on x comma x dash, it checks whether these two samples or whether these two elements are similar or not similar. It produces some real value based on the value. If the value is low, means they are more similar. The value is low means they are more similar. If the value is high means they are more dissimilar. Suppose the dissimilarity function for a data set D, 1/d². The dissimilarity function for a data set, for a set of instances D, is 1/d² sigma. Suppose x belongs to D, x dash also belongs to D. S dash belongs to D. Dissimilarity function of x comma x dash. This is called the cluster dissimilarity. Remember, this definition is very, very important. So for dissimilarity between two instances is calculated as simply dissimilarity of x comma x dash. Find out the cluster similarity. The cluster similarity for a set of instances is equal to average of all the similarities. Now these clustering trees are constructed by using two ways. One is by using dissimilarity matrix. Second one is by using Euclidean distance. Now consider the same example that is considered in the regression tree. That means the model and the condition and less like. So I am also considering the same example. Now I will write down the example. Now consider this one. We are considering the same example. So in the previous example, that is in regression trees, we have three features: model, condition and sleep. And the these are the different models. These are different conditions. These are different less like. And here we are writing, suppose A100, if you know the topic, A100 contains three values, that is three branches. In the regression tree, I am writing the prices. Suppose here price is not at all important for clustering tree. The price is not important, so I am writing the transaction number. Suppose in the previous table, serial number 129. So A100 occurs at serial number 368. P3 is the first row. So if you know the previous table, the construction is very simple. Instead of prices, I am simply writing the transition or transaction number. Now this is the dissimilarity matrix. If you are given this input only, I am calculating this one. So the dissimilarity matrix. Based on this dissimilarity matrix, I am calculating the operations. Suppose first I am calculating the dissimilarity for 3, 6 and 8. Suppose I am calculating the dissimilarity for 3, 6, 8. So for this one, how we are calculating dissimilarity? We already know the formula, 1 by d square into sigma x belongs to d. X dash also belongs to d. X belongs to D, X dash also belongs to D. Dissimilarity of X comma X dash. For example, for this one, 1 by D square, how many number of elements we have? We have 3 elements. So 1 by 3 square. Calculate dissimilarity of each and every one. So for this, what are the pairs? 3, 3. Suppose dissimilarity of, for each and every one, I am writing dissimilarity of 3, 3, 3, 6 plus 3, 8. So the combinations, dissimilarity of 3, 3, instance 3, instance 6, instance 3, instance 8. Similarity, dissimilarity of 6, 3 plus dissimilarity of 6, 8 plus dissimilarity of 6, 6. Similarly with 8, 8, 3. 8 6 8 8. So you know, observe the procedure. The procedure is 1 by d square. The d means the number of instances in this set. 1 by d square, that is 1 by 3 square into, for all possible combinations we have 3 terms. So 3 elements means a total of 9 combinations. So answer is 1 by 9 into the dissimilarity of, so these are the transaction numbers, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Similarly 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Observe 3 comma 3, so this one 3 3 value is 0 plus 3 6. 3 3 completed, 3 6 the value is 1 plus 3 8 the value is 2 plus 6 3 the value is 1 plus 6, 8. The value is 1 plus 6, 6. The value is 0. Because all diagonal values are 0. Because the dissimilarity between the same instances is 0. That means we already discussed it. If the dissimilarity value is low, means they are more similar. That instance is more similar to that instance. So the value is 0. The less value, more similar. Okay. Next, 8, 3, 2 plus 8, 6, 1, 8, 8, 0. So, 1 plus 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. So, the value is 8 by 9. The value is 8 by 9. Suppose if you are calculating, that you are getting 0.789. So, normal mathematical calculations. So, 3, 6, 8. In the similar manner. Next, what is the dissimilarity for 1? 1 is 1, 9 is 9, 5 is 5. Because it contains only a single values. Similarly, calculate 2, 4, 7. Calculate for 2, 4, 7 in the same procedure. If you are calculating for 2, 4, 7. That means 2, 2, 2, 4, 2, 7. 4, 2, 4, 4, 4, 7. 7, 2, 7, 4, 7, 7. observe the matrix and write down all the values. By write down all the values, we are getting the value of 0.22. So what is our final step? Final step is average weighted dissimilarity. Average weighted dissimilarity. The formula is same for first set. The number of elements are 3. Total number of elements are 9. The total number of transitions are 9. So the number of elements are 3. 3 by 9 into what is the dissimilarity for first set? The first set is 0.89 plus. We contains only one element. 1 by 9 into what is the dissimilarity? It contains only a single element. The dissimilarity is 0 plus 9 by 9 because 1, 1 value is 0. 9 by 9. 1 by 9 into 9 by 9 into 1 by 9 into 0 plus 5 means only one element. Again 1 by 9 into 0 plus 3 by 9 into 0.22. So what is the value we are getting? I am getting the value of 0.37. This is the average weighted dissimilarity for model. Average weighted dissimilarity for model. Okay, I am erasing this one. Procedure is very simple. So what is the value we are getting? For model, I am getting the value of 0.37. Similarly, for condition also apply the same procedure. For condition also apply the same procedure. 1166. 1116. 6166. Sum of all the values. Sum of all the values. 1 by 2 square. 1 by 2 square into all the values. 1 by 4 square. 1 by 3 square. The procedure is same. And finally, perform the same operation. Perform the same operation. What we are getting? So we are getting 0.86 for Leslie. I am getting 2.89. Which one we have selected? Which one we have selected? The less value means the more similar. Less value means the more similar. So at the top level, we are dividing based on model. Okay. So again, after that the model has three branches and again apply the same procedure. We already discussed in the regression tree. Here the same concept is repeated multiple number of times. The entire procedure is same. Simply changes only the formula. But the final formula, remember the final formula is always same. Average means the set of elements by total number of elements into the set of elements by total number of elements into, if you are using regression, into variance. If you are using clustering, into dissimilar value. Now, so one question is, how we are labeling the clusters? So I am designing the cluster. Suppose a cluster tree is constructed. How we are labeling the clusters? Remember, we label the clusters. I am erasing this one. The clusters are labeled. The clusters are labeled by using representative instance. So one main question is, how the clusters are labeled? The clusters are labeled by using representative instance. What is a representative instance? Representative instance means the sum of square distance from that instance to all other instances is low. Suppose consider 3, 6, 7. Suppose the first example is 3, 6, 8 is my first split in model. What is the dissimilarity between 3 and 6? In this, what is the representative instance? Suppose 3 and 6. 3 to 6, the value is 1. 3 to 8, the value is 2. So remember, 3 to 6, the value is 1. 3 to 8, the value is 2. Suppose consider 6. 6 to 3, the value is 1. 6 to 8, the value is 1. Similarly, 8 to 3, the value is 2. 8 to 6, the value is 1. So observe, which one is the representative instance here? Representative instance means all the dissimilarities are low. That particular instance to all other instances in the group have low dissimilarity. Suppose 3, 3 to 6, 3 to 8, the values are 1 comma 2. 8 to 3, 8 to 6, the values are 2 comma 4. But observe, from 6 to 3 and 6 to 8, we have low values. So 6 is the representative instance. 6 is the representative instance. We are constructing the tree by using this representative instance.